Another pretty cool room. Court of Owls mask. Okay, so she was the girl in that picture that I said looked creepy with the lion. I'm gonna imagine anyway.
I grew up looking at Molly's room through the peephole.
Oh.
Being inside for the first time, I felt like I'd stepped behind a painting.
So we are in Molly's room. Molly was really into Bedbug. Book of Memories, Call of the Wild. Alice in Wonderland. I guess it is public domain now. The Little Glass Slipper, Fairy Tales of Charles, Can't Quite Read the Texture.
I got the sense Edie had spent a lot of time here before my mom sealed the doors.
Oh, there's a lot to look at, and I don't know where to go. Let's start with the drawer.
Molly's gerbil had a tiny bedroom with its own even tinier gerbil cage.
That's cute. That skull, less cute. December 1947. Nice view. Molly Fitch.
December 13th, 1947. Dear diary, I'll be gone soon, but I wanted to tell somebody about what's gonna happen. It started when Mom sent me to bed without dinner. I woke up and I was starving, so I looked around for something to eat.
In your little pumpkin case. So I guess if it wasn't clear, I imagine we're Molly now.
My Halloween candy was all gone.
Am I gonna eat your gerbil?
The gerbil food was dry, but I didn't mind it.
What's your gerbil gonna eat? Rude.
Eating Christopher, but I held back.
You can't be that hungry, Molly.
I kept eating and eating.
Oh, the toothpick. No, Molly. You weird 1940s kids. The war screw you up that badly?
I ate a lot of things that night.
Why don't you have some toilet water too, you weird gremlin?
Then I heard chirping outside my window.
Huh. Little bird.
It was a barn swallow going back to her nest. I reached out for her. And suddenly.
Whoa.
I was a cat.
Just when I thought those 40 children couldn't get any weird, it turns out the yiff dates back all the way to the 40s. Come here, you damn bird. Oh, there's my jump. I'm gonna get you, bird.
I tried to be quiet, but the bird was really scared.
It's weird that I don't see anybody in the house. There you are, bird. Shit.
Mom and Dad didn't even look at me.
Mom and Dad look like they're made of clay. I gotta say, I'm enjoying playing as a cat. We need more cat games. Yeah. I saw something up there. I want it. I'm gonna eat your children. You're a lucky bird. As you might imagine, this is fairly on rails. I can't really fall off, but it's still really cool to play as a kitty cat. We don't get a lot of cat games. There you are, bird. I'm gonna sneak up on you. I'm gonna drop down on you.
I could tell she was getting really tired.
God damn it. Someone's got a pretty kick-ass treehouse spot. I'm actually gonna feel bad if I catch that bird. Oh, you got way
now
up there.
I was up in the big tree. I promised Dad I wouldn't climb it anymore. All I cared about was eating that mama bird.
Yeah, but why are you a cat? We haven't gotten over that yet.
I gobbled her up.
Oh, Jesus.
And suddenly, I was an owl. First, all I heard was the wind. Then I heard little teeth nibbling in the grass.
Holy shit. Right away, this just makes me want to play games where you play as an animal. I want to catch field mice as an owl.
Rabbits.
I'm gonna get you rabbits. I missed, I think. There you are. Yeah. Oh, this is fucking awesome.
Looking up and seeing mine through my talons. I swallowed him up, and I didn't chew one bit. Then I flew off to find something bigger.
What weird snake jaw do you... does this owl have? Alright, what are we looking for? Am I gonna catch
a mama rabbit!
Oh. Ooh. Oh, that made me... Oh, that hurt my stomach. I don't know what's going on there. That was a weird glitch, I guess. I totally lost that rabbit. I'm gonna get ya.
She was almost too big to carry. I started choking, but I couldn't stop eating.
You were a very hungry child.
Suddenly, I was a shark.
Oh, watch out for those tree sharks. This is amazing. Oh, jeez. Oh. Oh.
I rolled off
the street sharks
into the ocean. Now, I was hungrier.
Yeah, I would hope so. Give me that fish. I'm gonna fuck up that fish. Where'd you go? There you are.
That juicy seals.
Oh, that's a seal. I'm having a hard time controlling the shark. Much harder than the owl. There we go.
I tore off her flipper, and it tasted really good.
Kid, you're really... Like, you went from kinda cute to kinda weird to now you make me really uncomfortable.
Grabbed on tight. When I was so hungry, I jumped out of the water. When I opened my eyes, everything had changed.
What am I now? Oh, no. Oh, I don't like this. Ew. Oh, this makes me so uncomfortable.
Now I was a monster and I smelled people everywhere.
I don't like tentacles. But monsters gotta eat. I guess this is not the way we're going. Fuck you, bucket.
I was big, but I moved real quiet.
I'm gonna get you. Jesus. What game it? What is this game?
I wanted to stop, but also I didn't.
Oh, I can't in good conscience let you live after you're singing that song. I'll give you a chance. I only wanted to knock over a stool. I didn't want to kill a man. I mean, it would have killed him eventually, but... Whoops, missed the stairs. Oh god, the game's freaking out. Get up those stairs. I'm sorry, Captain. It's time for you to go.
After the last passenger, I was still hungry. And across the water, I smelled something new. Something I had to have, so I swam towards it.
Am I still a monster? Yep.
I slithered onto the sand, and the good smell went into an old pipe.
What could be better than human flesh? Oh no. Oh, we're coming out of the toilet.
I got closer and closer.
Oh, back in Molly's room. Am I gonna eat Molly? I'm gonna eat Molly. I'm making the game freak out a little bit.
All my stomach started growling. And suddenly, that was me again. I held my breath for a long time, but I couldn't hear anything. I think it's waiting for me to fall asleep. But it's not going to wait much longer. It needs to be, and we both know I will be delicious.
You're one fucked up kid.
I'm not sure if I believed all of that, but I'm sure Edie would have.
Yeah. So that is the story of. Okay, so I guess everyone in my family is gonna have their own little mini story. Honestly, if they're as well put together as Molly, who was, I'm down to find out more about this really fucked up family that's into furryvore, I guess. This cat.
This will be obvious later, but my mom never told me any of these stories. Edie would have, but mom didn't like bringing up the past. Though, when we adopted a stray kitten, she was the one who named it Molly. I spent a lot of time in Great Grandma Edie's room.
Lurpy. Oh. She was a big fan of birds. Purply. Can't read that one's name. Jacques. Bob. Oh, Bob was a snake. Burpee. Derpy. Rob. Grandma
We
Edie,
got
you sh
along, and it was a good place to hide from my mom.
Grandma Edie, you sure knew how to name birds.
Edie gave a big interview about a mole man living under the Finch house. My mom was furious.
We're gonna family day out at Druid World.
I hadn't thought of myself as Edith Jr. for a long, long time.
Weird America, the Finches, home movies. Okay, so they're kind of known to the world to an extent.
One summer, they evacuated the island, but Edie refused to go. For a few weeks, she was a celebrity.
Okay. So Edie is a badass old woman. The mysteries of death and thereafter. Molly concepts. Yuck.
When Edie told people Sven was killed by a dragon, she could also have said he was building a dragon-shaped slide that collapsed. She could have, but she didn't.
That would explain the dragon thing in the lake outside. Not quite ready to leave yet.
Lewis died a week before we left, but Edie had already started to memorialize him.
Jesus. Many people in this family died. Molly, Barbara, Calvin, Sam, Walter. Walter was part Sasquatch with hands that big.
Her room was like a museum. For 500 years, the Finches have been famous throughout Norway for their fortune and misfortune. Odin Finch buries the latest victims of the family curse, his wife Ingeborg, and their newborn son, Johan.
Ingeborg? That's an awfully weird name. Sick
On
mutton
January
chops, though.
7th, 1937, he set sail with his family and his house, hoping to leave the curse behind.
Well, if the house is cursed, don't put the house on it. I don't know how you float a whole house. across the Atlantic Ocean.
But 40-foot waves off the coast of Washington send the house and Odin to the bottom of the sea.
Yeah. Yeah, that would happen.
Odin's daughter Edie, with husband Sven and baby Molly, step ashore on their new home, Orcas Island. Odin Finch is the first to be buried in the new family cemetery.
Okay, so that statue I saw earlier was a cemetery.
His daughter Edie is already dreaming of a new Finch house.
I guess that's it for the real news.
Whatever's wrong with this family, it goes back a long ways.
Ingeborg.